my boy. I've been expecting you.
Joanna. First stage hypnosis.
Oh, just a convenient way of stopping idle chatter on the train. She's not harmed. I'll bring her out of it. Now, wake. There's a friend here. Talk to him.
John.
This is abduction, you know.
Oh, dear me, no. No, no. She came quite willingly. You came willingly, didn't you? You remember, we discussed it, oh, at great length.
John, he's frightened, terrified of you.
I thought it was supposed to be the other way around.
He's trying to run away from you.
You see why I let her sleep, this idle chatter.
Carswell, I know now that you were right, and I was wrong.
Really?
But there is a way out for me. You always said so. Yeah.
What's this?
Read it. You want me to admit your power. You can send this to any newspaper and photostatic copies to all your followers. Isn't that what you want?
Yes, but it's too late now. It's 6 minutes to 10.
Well, I guess it was my fault for not listening to Joanna. I'm sorry now that I didn't listen. And I want to thank you for convincing me of the existence of a world I never thought possible.
If only you'd understood sooner.
I suppose I still have time for a last cigarette.
Joanna.
Shall I go?
No, thank you. I've stopped smoking.
It must have been quite recently. You got a match?
Ah, yes, of course.
Thank you.
That's all right. You keep them. I shan't need them anymore.
You're very generous.
Well, I leave you two alone. I know there's a certain feeling between you, and you might want to be alone.
Sit down. Your generosity is becoming overwhelming as it gets closer to 10 o'clock. You're staying with me, Carswell. You've sold your bill of goods too well, because I believe you now. I believe that in 5 minutes, something monstrous and horrible is going to happen. And when it does, you're going to be here so that whatever happens to me will happen to you.
You're insane. You can't do this.
No. You're staying here, Carswell. You're staying right here.
No! Let him go, Holden! This man's insane. I must go.
It's all right, Doctor. We're the police, as Holden knows. We've had you under observation more or less at his request. Fortunately for you, as you can see.
Oh, yes, I see. Thank you.
It's obvious that Holden has got a bit of a persecution complex about you. Something about your putting a hex on him.
Well, that's utterly ridiculous. Now, if you'll excuse me, I'm getting out of this station.
John, he's lying. He bought a ticket to Southampton. I saw it myself.
This is idiotic. I can leave this train when I want. Excuse me.
Here's your book.
No, it's not mine. I found it here when I got on the train.
Your bags, sir?
My bag. Yes, of course.
Yes. These are his, too.
Well, you want your hat and coat, don't you, sir?
My coat. Oh, yes. Very forgetful of me. Thank you very much. You passed them. You slipped them in my pocket.
It's 2 minutes of 10.
Come on.